It's one-on-one. Bret the Hitman Hart against Shawn Michaels of the Rockers. We'll take you back last week to the Superstars of Wrestling. Highlights from a match as Jake the Snake Roberts met the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. From there, singles competition from Brutus the Barber of Beefcake. And in tag team action, it's the Colossal Connection. But right now, let's go to ringside.
And what a career he's having.
I think Pete Sanchez could use a haircut. As a matter of fact, we thought not too long ago that the genius could use a haircut, and he's got one.
In fact, he got one. 3-2, no charge. I want him to take a little bit more off the bat, though, Tony.
I'm sure he'll get his chance, but as far as Mr. Birmingham, the genius, are concerned, he'll never get that chance again, and they have something to say about that haircut. Let's listen in to both of those guys.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake, you stuck your nose in Mr. Perfect's business by cutting the genius's hair. But you also found you never, ever crossed Mr. Perfect.
Well, they're a little bit upset. I don't blame them for being upset, but maybe Mr. Perfect could use a little clipping as well.
Certainly some off the back, wouldn't you say?
Well, Brutai will be more than willing to oblige anyone, I'm sure.
And it costs nothing.
Absolutely free.
Sanchez complaining now to the referee about, what was it, pulling the hair? Breaking from the ropes, that's what it was.
Sanchez looks like he's up around that 300-pound mark.
Well, we've seen Brutus go up against big men before, and that has not really deterred him at all. What a phenomenal athlete he is in the WWF. Right there, Sanchez slipped in a knee. I thought that wasn't having any effect, but that turnbuckle was right on target.
Well, there's nothing underneath that cloth but some steel, Tony, and right between the eyes, and sort of woke Brutai up a little bit. Look out.
Good reversal from Beefcake. Good back body drop. Brutus right to the attack once again. One of his strong suits has always been, once he has a man down, he does not let up. And that's what he's doing right there.
Whoa. That'll shake the cobwebs loose for sure.
He's ready to put him to sleep already. Didn't take long. Perfect are looking on, and remember about the genius going to sleep, because here we go into the ropes. There is the sleeper hold behind Sanchez. It usually doesn't take long for him to put his opponent out, and let's see how long it takes here.
Doesn't take long to stop that flow of blood through the carotid artery once you can't reach the brain anymore. No oxygen up there, and just like the game's over, the lights go out. Here's somebody that's not asleep. We're going to go to a ring announcer. Here's Mike. Those hedge clippers.
Set to go and ready to do some handiwork on Pete Sanchez. And certainly Mr. Perfect would like the chance to get into the ring against Brutus the Barber Beefcake and maybe even try to cut some of the hair off of Brutus himself.
Well, I wouldn't put it past Mr. Perfect. He said he can do anything. Whether he can cut hair or not remains to be seen, but should he get the opportunity to get his hands on those shears, don't tell him.
Don't tell me what he'll do. Right now, we're ready for our announcement of the main event for WrestleMania 6.
From the World Wrestling Federation magazine, this is Special Report.
Hello, everyone. I'm Lord Alfred Hayes. WrestleMania 6 grows ever closer. Sunday, April the 1st at Sky Dome, Toronto, Canada. You can purchase those tickets right now by phone. Call 1-416-872-1111. Now, last week we heard these intense challenges issued by Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior.
Ultimate Warrior, me and my Hulkamaniacs put the WWF Championship on the line. We challenge you, Warrior. We've got to know what the strongest force is in the WWF. And I swear by the number one Hulkamaniac up there, Ultimate Warrior, the darkness that you press your opponents into before you beat them, if that's the same darkness that makes your soul live, if that's where your heart is at, if you ride your Harley Davidson side by side with the devil, and if I find out that the power you possess comes from drinking the sweat from the devil's armpit. By God, I'll strike you down, Ultimate Warrior. What you gonna do when Hulkamania in the Ultimate Challenge destroys you? Things that hang from my body and the reasons I paint my face only add more area for more warriors to hang on. You, Hulk Hogan, see things as you will, but I need not come from behind or take a cheap shot at anyone or anything. You, Hulk Hogan, will only be approached by the warriors face to face, eye to eye. I bring you, Hulk Hogan, the one and only Ultimate Challenge.
This week, relative to those provocative challenges, the World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney made this official announcement.
Thank you. On April 1st in Toronto, Canada at Sky Dome, the World Wrestling Federation will present WrestleMania. At this time, I am happy to announce the main event in which World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan will meet the Intercontinental champion, the Ultimate Warrior. Unquestionably, this is the greatest main event ever signed in World Wrestling Federation history. Never before have two men been so equally matched in popularity, in strength, and in stamina. However, the only question yet to be resolved is, whose championship will be defended? That question will be answered at a later date. Thank you.
It is now official. With the authorization of the World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney, the main event for WrestleMania 6 will be the Ultimate Challenge. Hulk Hogan versus the Ultimate Warrior. The only question left to be answered is whose title will be at stake. That question will be answered in the weeks to come. For the World Wrestling Federation, this has been Special Report.
B-5-O-Fum!
Come on, you guys. Only a little.
A hungry giant!
Hungry for a big honey dash.
Big taste, honeycomb, big taste.
Honeycomb, big, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not small.
No, no, no. Honeycomb's got big, 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 big crust for a big, big bite.
Honeycomb cereal, part of this big, complete breakfast.
Honeycomb, big, big bite.
Unquestionably, Gorilla Monsoon, the greatest main event in WrestleMania history, the Ultimate Warrior, and Hulk Hogan, the Ultimate Challenge.
No question in my mind either, Tony Schiavone. I can't ever remember the WWF champion challenging and having a challenge accepted by the Intercontinental champion. And for that matter, what belts are at stake here?
Well, as Jack Tunney tells us, we'll find out in the weeks to come as to what belt is on the line.
Take a look at these two beauties, two former Intercontinental champions.
Behind this team.
Up against Bill and Tony Mulkey in this event.
These are the Mulkey brothers.
The Mulkey brothers. And as we take a look at the megaphone, you know, I know the Colonel very happy about Rhythm and Blues.
This is the greatest tag team ever assembled. It's red hot. It's Rhythm and Blues.
That's right. The Mulkey man, he's got the rhythm. And the hammer will give you the blues.
Surprise me if the Colonel could bring these two right to the top of tag team competition and get once more the WWF Tag Team Championships in his stable.
Well, girl, I've always thought, and I'm sure you will agree, that when you have two top caliber athletes, even though they may have not worked together that often, they can sooner or later gel as a team.
Well, if you've got experience, if you've got know-how, if you've got technique, and if you've got the ability and the kind of experience that these two have had, they can't help but gel.
And in that, they have some great leadership.
Of course, it doesn't take much gelling against the Mulkey brothers here, but they certainly leave a lot to be desired.
And they sent Tony Mulkey back in.
You know, I can't get my mind off what we just saw moments ago, Tony Schiavone. Did you see? I've never seen the Hulkster so intense. And for that matter, the Warrior so intense.
event it will be at Sky Dome in Toronto as the Hammer lifts up Tony Volpe. Great shoulder breaker. Now, what's been great about this team, Gorilla, is that they've been able, we had talked about gelling as a team, but they are tagging back and forth, in and out quite well.
Continuity is what tag team wrestling is all about, and if you don't have that, regardless of what kind of ability you have, you're going to come up with a short end of the stick. Look out, Hammer's about to level this youngster.
Takes him for the ride. Whoa. Wow. That time he hit the small of his back. Hard on that back body drop.
Hulk, you look like one of the fine Melindas there going there. He was really up there.
One thing about Honky Tonk as the Colonel has his hands agape is that you certainly know that every time Honky hits you or does something to you, everything is on target.
Certainly is. Everything well placed, every move well coordinated. Now, Mulkey just draped over there. Referee, you know, you could call this match at any time.
Bill Mulkey is going to the wrong corner. He went right toward a neutral corner that time.
Oh, here it comes.
You have to shake, rattle, and roll. Oh, once again.
Beautifully executed.
It sure was.
It's all over just like that.
Days now, this Thursday evening, the action arriving right here in Nashville. It begins at 7:30 p.m., and what a lineup is on the way. Now, momentarily, we will hear from the model, Rick Martel, talking about a return encounter. But first, let's review the rest of the action. Now, Tugboat Thomas, he will dock right here in Nashville when he meets the Brooklyn Brawler, and that is going to be some battle. Tugboat making quite a name for himself. The Mighty Hercules, he takes on the Genius in tag team competition, the Bushwhackers, Luke and Butch. They meet the Russian Bolsheviks, Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov. His record is still intact. Mr. Perfect, accompanied by the Genius when he battles Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And in the main event, still fresh in the memory of Dusty Rhodes and Sapphire, the last time they met the Macho King Randy Savage and Sensational Queen Sherry. It comes to a head right here this Thursday evening. But right now it's the model talking about Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Beefcake, a man as ignorant as you, a man as low class as you, wouldn't understand the value of my clothes that you destroyed on TV. You will understand that these clothes were designer's clothes, designed especially for the model. Just to give you an idea for your simple mind, so you can figure it out. This one coat alone that you destroyed was worth more than your whole wardrobe. Yes, I go through a great deal when I shuffle my clothes. I get the best to make sure I look great all the time. And you went and touched and destroyed him on TV. Try to make a fool of the model. It's not going to work. I'm going to make an example out of you. Yes, I'm going to finish you off once and for all.
The model Rick Martel, he will not rest until he has avenged his wardrobe. The Brooklyn Brawler, he faces Tugboat.
Oh, ashore, it's going ashore. Brawler, I'm here for you, brother. Let me tell you, I heard you don't know a hammerlock from a headlock. Well, neither do I. Is this intelligent looking? Well, let me tell you, you're a street fighter, so am I. In the alleys, on the floor, on the ceiling, hanging from a chandelier. I don't care, but I'm coming to town, so you better prepare.
Rough seas ahead for the Brooklyn Brawler. He meets Tugboat Thomas this Thursday night, February 15th at the Nashville Auditorium. Right now, feel the power of the WWF.
Nintendo Entertainment System presents Dusty Rhodes. He rocks and rolls while Sapphire keeps the rhythm at ringside. Dusty picks up the beat because the name of this tune's the Polka Dot Drop. And there's still a whole lot of shaking going on. This jam-packed Fort Myers, Lee Kelly Civic Center, jam-packed on their feet for the Birdman Coco Beware. Take a look at this crowd on hand here. WWF Wrestling Challenge. And equipment so much a part of Coco Beware. We think back now onto the big announcement that was made earlier on by Jack Tunney, and still some more announcements to be made, especially as to whose title will be on the line, the Hulksters or the Ultimate Warriors, or maybe both of them.
Well, how long are we going to have to wait for that guy to make a decision, Tony? That's what I want to know.
Hey, he's the press. I'm not going to press him.
Well, I will. I've known him for many years. Look out. Oh, nice maneuver.
Too much quickness here, Gorilla. Once again, a deep on drag. From Coco Beware. Watch out. Booth wants to hold things up here. No hair grabbing right there at all as Danny Davis checks with Coco Beware. That's just too much Coco for his opponent.
Obviously, Tony, we missed some of the verbal confrontation, at least I did, between the Hulkster and the Ultimate Warrior. I must have missed something somewhere along the way. I'm sure everybody did because these guys are really upset.
Yeah, they went nose to nose. We have seen that.
Nice backdrop.
Coco gets a good backdrop.
I think Coco would like to have his matches while his music is still playing throughout the entire match.
Maybe he would get him some rhythm. He's got a great rhythm in the ring, though.
He certainly does.
Good pickup. Coco showing his power. We talk so much about the quickness of Coco Beware, but also very strong. Here he is.
He's going all the way up.
Coco up top. With the drop kick.
Came right down on his feet. Boy, does that take balance.
Respond as Coco shows to everyone that he's about to apply the Ghostbuster to Booth. There it is.
The Terminator, anyone's career right there.
Wrong, the back of the net.
Knocked him silly. Forget about it.
The man of the three count after the Ghostbuster for Coco Beware.
The Birdman, Coco Beware.
Nice shot over the beak of Frankie there. As Coco chucks up another one into Wing Column here this week on Wrestling Challenge. Out there. Look at him. Let's go back and take a look at some of the highlights. Has Coco really looked good here this week? You know how hard it is to do this, Tony Schiavone, land on your feet after delivering a drop kick like that, and then polish it off with your favorite maneuver that gives you Excedrin headache number 35. Wow.
Winner Coco Beware, and there he is with Frankie. Right now, let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, my guest, ladies and gentlemen, this week is one of the great veterans in the World Wrestling Federation. He is from Harlem. He is none other than Bad News Brown. Recently, Bad News of the Royal Rumble, you had to be a favorite after winning prestigious battle royals in the past, but the way things turned out, it had to be somewhat of a disappointment.
Let me tell you something, and let me tell these beer-belly sharecroppers one thing. When you grow up on the streets of Harlem, Friday, Saturday, and especially Sunday is Rumble night. So this was all
has had more singles competition, I'm sure, than Shawn Michaels has had.
The pink and black attack. And it appears that Neidhart and Jannetty both are not in a hurry, leaving the ringside area.
Well, they're going to be allowed to stay out there, stay in a corner, mind their own business, and watch, just as we are. Oh, there go the shades.
That time it was the anvil delivering the Hitman shades to somewhat ringside, and we are set for what should be a great matchup, because I think both these men match up quite well.
They certainly do. We're going to see some great moves here. You can bet on that. Some quick moves.
Back to the ropes.
Should be a relatively clean match.
Hopefully.
Well, you never know. Sparks start flying. Everything is possible.
The tie-up and right to a top wrist lock for Bret Hart.
They were both noticeably excitable when they found out that they'd signed contracts with the other's name on it.
Nice job that time of Shawn Michaels getting out of that hold with that arm drag. Once again to the tie-up, so it's Shawn Michaels' turn. This time with a wrist lock. Great reversal. We're going to see a lot of reversals, I'm sure, before this match is finished.
Hitman looking for a leg back there. Oh, nice. Ducked right in, turned it into that nice hammerlock. You know, these matches always start out like this, Tony Schiavone, but somewhere along the way, nobody likes to get shown up. And sooner or later, one of these guys is going to make a mistake, and he's going to start to look bad out there, and then anything. Nice. Oh, caught in midair.
Yes, sir, and dropped him down with a reversal. Atomic drop. Well, that decked him.
Nothing wrong with that. Perfectly legal move.
That's right. Both of them were.
Fans didn't think so, but they're wrong.
All right, the Hitman, the Steam. He missed the elbow. Maybe telegraphed it a little bit. Shawn Michaels popped right up.
Shawn has that quickness. It makes the Rockers such a formidable team. Boy, hung onto that headlock. Really, look at the neck, back of the neck of that, the anvil out there. Oh, what a move!
Later on East Street, dropkick, Shawn Michaels, once again. How many different sensational moves have we seen from Michaels and Jannetty?
Well, the Hitman's not hurt all that bad. I got news for you.
You're right. Pop right up, girl.
Oh, three quarters of the way across the ring.
Shoved him right out to the center of the ring.
That's something to say to Jannetty as well.
You're right about sparks flying. I think they're starting already.
Well, nobody likes to get shown up. Nice forearm blows. Also legal.
Yeah.
A short block. Oh, backslide.
He was waiting on it. He's got a two count, almost a three. First one to get a blow, and that's so important now. Sending Shawn Michaels with a head of steam in. Picks him up. Shawn Michaels over the top. Oh, my goodness.
He's mounted to a slam. 360 in order to do that. He didn't find a mark with that. Look at Marty. He's getting excited.
Shawn moving a little slowly, though, right there. After those blows from the Hitman. Now to the ropes again. Here we go. This pace is furious, and they both go down.
Never understood why someone would do that. Come up the rope and do a 360 and get clobbered. Well,
he wanted to do that time. The vertical suplex did not. Shawn couldn't get him over either. The Hitman trying once again. Back into the rock.
So right there.
Yeah. Got to get involved as a referee. No break here. And Jannetty up on the apron. And now the tempers are really boiling between both men. April 1st is the date to remember. It certainly will be the greatest meet event of all time. And we will hear some more matches for WrestleMania 6 in the weeks to come.
Well, if nothing else, Tony Schiavone, the ramifications of both titles has to make it the greatest main event ever in the history of WrestleMania. Sky Dome will go down in history. You can bet those phones are ringing off the hook right now.
Not only consider the ramifications of the titles, but consider the participants and the success of the Hulkster and the Ultimate Warrior. Wow.
Earthquake. What a force he has become here in the World Wrestling Federation. All 500 pounds of him.
Too much earthquake here for Jim Evans, I do believe. Look at this. Wow.
Well, on the newsstands this Tuesday, the latest edition of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, the Hulkster himself on the cover. Special edition. You want to know some more about this guy, the Earthquake, you can find it inside this particular edition of the WWF magazine.
I don't think Jim Evans wants to know much more about it.
He knows too much about it already.
He knows how much he weighs right now. All 480 plus pounds down on Jim Evans. He's not finished. Big Evans!
I guess it all depends on what he ate last, Tony. Whether he's over that 500 pound mark or not.
Here's the tremor.
He's already destroyed a half a dozen rings here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Watch out! The tremor and that earthquake! Listen to the fans to do it all when he lands on his unfortunate opponent.
Here is your winner, Earthquake!
I think Colonel Jimmy Hart wants it to happen again.
Well, he's having a good time here at the expense of a lot of people.
Oh, no!
Oh, that wasn't necessary. We got to get the referees to stop that. Stop allowing that to happen. Power, just like nothing, just like catching a bag of garbage. Rocking all that 500 pounds, and then to add insult to injury, an additional time. Oh, give me a break. This guy's going to have to be hospitalized.
He knows how to use his weights, and unfortunately, Jim Evans has to be helped away from the ring area. Your winner, the Earthquake. Let's go to the event center.
Too much time remaining. It happens this Thursday evening, February 15th. We haven't quite reached the panic stage, but we are awfully close. The place to be, the Nashville Auditorium. Mr. Perfect. He faces Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Right now, Hacksaw is standing by with a message for the Flawless One.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Old Hacksaw Jim Duggan is going to try to keep my composure, even though I'm coming out of here talking about a man like Mr. Perfect. You, get out of here. People are trying to interrupt me and makes me mad. Mr. Perfect, I'm sick and tired of a guy like you that comes down here combing those long, curly locks, talking about what a great body he has, talking about how he plays basketball and pool and backgammon. Well, that's great, Mr. Perfect, because the only thing Hacksaw Jim Duggan does well is beating people up. And when I get you in the ring, I guarantee you, I'm going to do what I do best, tough guy. Hello!
According to Hacksaw, it all ends right here in Nashville this Thursday evening when he meets Mr. Perfect. Dusty Rhodes, he battles the Macho King, Randy Savage, standing by with sensational Queen Sherry.
I'm not shut
shut up right
no,
now!
I'm
no,
not,
you're the one
no,
that got slapped,
not,
and I came in and I look
Rhodes,
like an idiot. Shut up right now. Shut up! You American dream, Dusty Rhodes, this will never happen again, because I'm going to take you in a little package here. And I'm going to make a real little surprise out of you, because you're a real little person, yeah. About that tall. You and your sapphire, you tell me some right now. You can make up for it all in one night. You can make anything all right.
The only thing that matters is you, and we get Rhodes and Sapphire, and we finish them. We're going to finish them.
Ever in the kingdom of the madness has already been done. You can't roll back time, Dusty Rhodes. You can't.
You can't do that.
You have no power to take back what you've done.
Never!
Sensational Queen Sherry remembers the rough treatment she got from Sapphire. All four will meet. Dusty Rhodes meeting the Macho King, Randy Savage, this Thursday night at the Nashville Auditorium. You can still be a part of it, but you better hurry.
Take you back last week to the Superstars of Wrestling. We join in progress a match between Jake the Snake Roberts and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.
What's he trying to do? Meanwhile, he's going to be carried outside the ring. Look at this. They're going at it outside. Wait a minute. The big boss man in the wrong way is saying...
the thief. You go get the police. And I went out and I bought the best police protection that money can buy. That's right, and I'd like to thank you, Slick, right here publicly for a job well done. You were very well paid, and the services were rendered, and you were very well paid. Now it's time to deliver.
Wait a minute. What's this about money? What's this about a payoff?
Wait a minute, brother. What you getting your danger ball up about? Now, I wouldn't call it a payoff. Let's just say Mr. DiBiase has given us a small token of his esteem. Let's just say a little donation.
Donation? It doesn't sound like a donation to me. You told me I was going to go out and retrieve stolen property. You didn't say nothing about no payoff.
Wait a minute. What's going on here, Slick? Let me tell you something. I bought and paid for your services. Now it's time to deliver. Boss man, you have been paid. Now it's time to deliver the goods. So stick your hand in the bag and pull out my belt and give it to me.
Wait a minute, you fat-faced punk. Nobody tells the big boss man what to do.
Let me tell you something, boss man. It's not the money, because any man with any brains would not refuse the kind of money I've given you. What it is you're just plain scared. You're just afraid to stick your hand in that bag and get my belt. So if you're scared, just say scared.
Look at my eyes, boy. Don't I look like a man that's scared of anything? Well, let me tell you something. I'm not scared of any beast, man or not, and I especially ain't scared of you. I tell you what, boy. I'm going to show you what scared is. I'm going to show you what afraid.
What's he done? He's going in the bag. Big Boss Man is going in the bag. He has the million.
This is what your money bought and paid for. Well, if you want it, you're going to have to get it the old-fashioned way. You're going to have to earn it.
What? Slick, what you doing?
What you doing?
Put it back in the bag.
I may be a lot of things, boy, but I can't be bought, and I sure ain't no thief.
Whoa. I can't believe this, Jesse.
Mistake was questioning the honor and integrity of the big boss man. You don't question your uniform. You don't question the name of the big boss man and what I stand for. Second mistake, boy, was you lied to me. You lied to me about property that belonged to Jake the Snake Roberts. Well, let me tell you something, punk. You can't make a thief out of me. You can't buy me. Just because DiBiase had money don't mean that you could buy the big boss man. You understand me, boy? DiBiase, let me get something straight to you, boy. How does it feel to find a man that you can't buy, that you can't own? Well, you're looking at him, standing tall, standing proud in the name of the law. Let me warn you, boy, the lifeblood that flows through your body that makes you the million-dollar man sheds just like any other man. Makes you just like any other man. And let me tell you something, punk. These cuffs were made for you. They're custom made, and you'll wear them if you step out of line with a big boss man.
What do you, Tony Schiavone? A lot upset.
I think he's upset, but I think he has his priorities in order, don't you?
Oh, he's right. No question about it. Million-dollar man is wrong 95% of the time anyway. The other
wrestling challenge certainly doesn't present a problem for them, I'm sure.
Always a mismatch. You know that?
Yeah.
Every time Andre's in the ring, there's some sort of mismatch going on.
And he's not in there for very long either.
And with Haku, he really doesn't need to be.
Are we going to get some further word this week from WWF President Jack Tunney, Tony, or are we? What's the deal?
In the coming weeks, I understand.
Oh, in the coming weeks. He was that specific to say coming weeks.
Coming weeks.
Well, a lot of those questions are answered in the World Wrestling Federation latest edition on the stands right now with the Hulkster on the cover. And boy, what a confrontation indeed. As inside, you'll find some more information on the Colossal Connection. These two guys may hold on to those belts forever.
Well, I'm sure as far as Demolition is concerned that the holding on to the belts forever will not last too long. But with moves like the Crescent Kick and Andre's big elbow, you're right, it may last a long time.
You know, the big plus going for them, I'll tell you about right after the ring announcer, right after we hear from Mike.
The World
Wrestling Federation
Tag Team Champions, the Colossal Connection.
Let's go to the event center, Gorilla.
I think we better.
Nashville Auditorium, that's the place to be this Thursday evening, beginning at 7:30 p.m. at the Nashville Auditorium. Now, the Bushwhackers in tag team competition, they meet the Russian Bolsheviks, Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov. They're standing by with more on this match.
Як ви поживаєте, товариші? Як ми там заб'ємо цей бушваків чорну землю? Як ви правда, товариш?
Правда, товариш. Bushwhackers, you're a very good tag team. You are very strong. But you don't have any brains, Bushwhackers. That's something you need if you want to be a winner in the World Wrestling Federation. Anyway, we're not going to have any problem taking you down and destroying you because we're after one thing, the World Wrestling Federation tag team titles, and no one, including you, can stop us.
Russian Bolsheviks, this Thursday, they plan to show what tag team competition is all about to the Bushwhackers. The Macho King, Randy Savage, he faces Dusty Rhodes.
Yeah, let me tell you about it. I was thinking all about it. The brothers on the street are talking about it. Everybody around the world seen it live. When one Queen Sherry started ridiculing the American dream, the common folk, if you will. I am folk, yes, sir. And Macho Man, the king, if you will, Randy Savage, said, I want Dusty Rhodes, the legendary American dream. Well, you got all of it you can stand, baby. Nobody runs down my people, my common folk, if you will, in public, much less my Lady Sappy. Come in here, darling.
Oh, yeah. Randy King, we got something for you, too.
Ooh, and I'm going to put it on you like she wrote you.
Dusty Rhodes has already proven that he will do whatever it takes to protect his manager, Sapphire. He faces the Macho King, Randy Savage, sensational Queen Sherry at ringside this Thursday night. Also at the Nashville Auditorium, Tugboat Thomas, set for singles competition. He battles the Brooklyn Brawler, the Genius, taking on the mighty Hercules. The Bushwhackers in tag team competition, they face the Russian Bolsheviks. In a return bout, Brutus the Barber Beefcake meets the model Rick Martel, Mr. Perfect, putting his record on the line. Once again, he faces Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the Genius, at ringside, and both managers present, Sapphire and sensational Queen Sherry at ringside, when Dusty Rhodes meets the Macho King Randy Savage. See it all this Thursday night, February 15th, at the Nashville Auditorium.
The Blockbuster Arcade Hit, two-player head-to-head action, Double Dragon 2, The Revenge.
I'd rather switch.
Be sure to join us next week for more great action on the Wrestling Challenge. Scheduled to join us, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, as well as Canadian strongman Dino Bravo. We'll announce more matches for WrestleMania 6, as well as, for the first time since the announcement of the main event for WrestleMania 6, comments from Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior. Tag team competition from the Powers of Pain. And our feature matchup next week, one-on-one, it's Dusty Rhodes against Rick the Model Martel. Right now, let's hear comments from both.
Oh, yeah, you know it's coming now. We're talking about Martel, the model, the handsome clothes-wearing dude. And next week on this television, live in public, if you will, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Sapphire. Hey, model this.